नमस्कार, हूँ आदर्श छू। वेलकम टू आदर्श एजुकेशन सोसाइटी। हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल स्टडी दी अनदर कंडीशन फॉर अ क्वाड्रिलेटरल टू बी अ पैरेललोग्राम। सो दिस प्रॉपर्टी इज स्टेटेड एज अ थ्योरम 8.8 एंड दैट इज द स्टेटमेंट इज अ क्वाड्रिलेटरल इज अ पैरेललोग्राम इफ a pair of opposite sides is equal and parallel. So this is the least requirement condition to make a quadrilateral a parallelogram. That is, if only one pair of opposite sides is equal and parallel. So let us take here one of the quadrilateral PQRS. Right? So here we can write down the given condition is that one pair of opposite sides is equal and parallel. So we are taking that RS side is equals to PQ side. So PQ is equals to RS. These also are parallel to each other, that PQ is parallel to RS. These two things we have given. Right? So now, as we have given that the two sides, one pair of opposite sides is equal and parallel. Now we have to prove that PQRS is a parallelogram. So here we can write down the two triangles are there, right? So in triangle PQR and triangle SRP, right? PQR and RSP. One condition we have given that PQ is equals to RS. PQ is equals to RS. This is the given condition. Second condition is that RP side is the common. PR is equals to RP. This is the common side in both the triangles. Now, here we have given that PQ is parallel to RS, and we can take PQ is equals to RS and PR is the transversal. PR is transversal, right? So now this angle and this angle will become equal according to the alternate interior angle. So this angle we can write down as angle QPR. Angle QPR will become equal to angle SRP according to the alternate interior angle, right? So now this side is there. So by side angle side criteria, now we can write down the triangle PQR is congruent to triangle RSP, right? As these two triangles are congruent, their corresponding parts will become equal, right? Their corresponding parts will become equal. So we can write down another condition is that RQ is equals to SP, or PS is equals to RQ. PQR is equals to SP by CPCT. Now you can see that one of the opposite sides we have given that is equal. In this quadrilateral, one pair of opposite side is equal. Here we prove that another side of a quadrilateral is also equal. That means both pair of opposite sides are equal. And there is a theorem which said that if in a quadrilateral both pair of opposite sides are equal, then it is an parallelogram, right? So this is, we can write down that, therefore we can write down that PQRS is a parallelogram, right? Because both pair of opposite sides, here we can write down that both pair of opposite sides are equal. both pair of opposite sides are equal. That is, PQRS is an parallelogram. So this is how we can prove this theorem number 8.8. And this is the least requirement condition, that if in a parallelogram only one pair of opposite sides is equal and parallel, then it is an parallelogram. Also, we can consider these two one pair of opposite sides, that PS and QR. If we have given that PS and QR are equal and parallel, then also we can prove in the same way that PQRS is an parallelogram. Okay, so let us use this theorem and study the example number 6. So here we have given that ABCD is an parallelogram. See, ABCD, we already have given that it is an parallelogram, right? P and Q are the midpoints of opposite side AB and CD. P is the midpoint of side AB, so this part and this part is equal. In the same way, Q is the midpoint of this side DC, so this part and this part are also equal. If we join AQ, then it is intersect DP as at point S. In the same way, BQ and CP intersect at a point R. So the first thing we have to prove is that APCQ is a parallelogram. First thing we have to prove is that APCQ is a parallelogram. Right? APCQ. See, APCQ is this type of quadrilateral. APCQ. Right? Currently, we have not given that it is a parallelogram. We have to prove that it is a parallelogram. Here, we have given that ABCD is a parallelogram. Right? So, we have given that AB is parallel to CD. Right? In a parallelogram, opposite sides are parallel. So, we can write down that AB is parallel to CD. Now, see, P is the point on the side AB. So, if AB is parallel to CD, then AP is also parallel to CD. So here we can write down that AP is parallel to, in the same way, instead of writing CD, we can write down CQ, right? Because this A, P and B are collinear, in the same way, C, Q and D are collinear, right? Let us understand one time more, that AB is parallel to CD. Then what is AP? AP is a part on the side AB. Then if AB is parallel to CD, then AP is also parallel to CD. In the same way, CD, in this we have to consider this part CQ, right? So CQ is a part on the CD. So if CD is parallel to AB, then CQ is parallel to AB. So here we can write down that AP and CQ are parallel to giving the equation number 1. Now we have given that P is the midpoint of side AB and Q is the midpoint of side CD. Okay, here according to the condition of parallelogram of ABCD, opposite sides are equal. So we can write down that AB is equals to CD. Right? This is again the property of a parallelogram. And that property is that opposite sides are equal. Now take the half both the side. If we divide both the side with 2, then what will happen? Now 1 half of AB. 1 half of AB, that means AP. And 1 half of CD, that means CQ. Right? Why? Because this AP and PB both are equal and both are half of AB. In the same way, DQ and CQ are also equal and they both are half of CD. So, half of AB we can write down AP and half of CD we can write down CQ. Give it the equation number 2. So, here you can see now from equation number 1 and 2 what we can say that, see, in a quadrilateral APCQ, one pair of opposite sides is equal, that is AP and CQ are equal, also they are parallel, AP and CQ are also parallel. So now using theorem number 8.8, we can say that APCQ is a better one. So therefore, from equation number 1, 2 and from the theorem number 8.8, now we can say that APCQ is a parallelogram. Right? So the first thing that we have to prove is that APCQ is a parallelogram. Now the second thing that we have to prove is that BPBQ is a parallelogram. So as we have proved that APCQ is a parallelogram, now we can prove that DPBQ is a parallelogram, right? As AB is parallel to CD, so PB is parallel to DQ and PB is also equal to DQ. So similarly, as we have proved that this is a parallelogram, similarly we can prove that DPBQ is a parallelogram. Right? Now the third one is that PSQR is a parallelogram. Right? Where is PSQR? PSQR, this interior quadrilateral, PSQR. Now we have to prove that it is an parallelogram. How we can prove that? See, here we know that we have proved that APCQ is a parallelogram, right? So PC and AQ are also become parallel because we have proved that APCQ is a parallelogram. So now both pair of opposite side of APCQ are parallel. So we can write down that AQ is parallel to PC. AQ is parallel to PC. From this, we can write down that if AP, AQ, then we can take one of the portion of this AQ, that is SQ. So SQ is parallel to, from that this PC, we have to take this portion PR. Right? This AP is parallel to PC, then SQ is parallel to PR. Because SQ is the part of AQ and PR is the part of PC. So this is the first, this we can write down that SQ is parallel to PR. In the same way, here we have proved that DPBQ is a parallelogram. DPBQ is also a parallelogram. So DP is parallel to BQ or QB. Here we can write down that DP is parallel to QB. Now we can see that SP is the part on DP. So SP is parallel to QR is a part on BQ. QR is a part on BQ. So these two parts are also become parallel. Now see, SQ is parallel to PR and SP is parallel to QR. See, SQ is parallel to PR and SP is parallel to QR. Right? That means both pair of opposite sides. See, both pair of opposite side of PSQR is parallel, then we can say that, therefore we can say that PSQR is a parallelogram. Right? What is the reason? Reason is that both pair of opposite sides are parallel and therefore PSQR is a parallelogram. Okay, so this is the another condition. From this we can prove that the two theorems, these statements, APCQ is a parallelogram and DPBQ is a parallelogram. Okay, so this is all about this lecture. Thank you.
Thank you for joining us.